A very good morning, children. We are here yet on another Sunday. We are glad to be together. We are glad to meet again. I am so happy for this opportunity. We thank God for it. And I pray that as we learn together today, we will be able to meet sooner other than later. So before we begin today, I'd like for us to take an opportunity, to take this opportunity to give thanks to God. I'd like for us to pray in tongues. We all know how to pray in tongues. So I'd like for us to take this opportunity, give thanks to God, and say a word of prayer, okay? Father, we thank you for this precious and glorious morning that you have given unto us, God. We thank you for the gift of your children, Father. We thank you, Father, that you have been able to, we are able to meet and gather in front of you again in the mighty name of Jesus. Ribosha saka harayaka tabama shasaka harayaka. Rokoto bama shasaka harayaka tabama shasaka hara. Rokoto shasa barayaka tabama shasaka garaya shasa. Rokoto bomoshoso kohoro yokoto bama shasaka harayaka. Rikiti shasa kabarayaka tabasha saka baraya. Hakatashasaraya. Kotosho sokohoroyo bomosho sokohoroyo katashasaba. Rikiti bamashasa kaharaya bamasha sakaharaya kata. Rokotosho sokohoroyo kotobomosho sokohoroyo ko. Rakata shasa kabaraya kata bamasha sakahara. Rakata shasa kabaraya kata bamasha sakaharaya ka. Rokoto bamasha sakaharaya kata bamasha sakagara. Rokotosho sokohoroyo kotobomosho sokohoroyo. Ribaka shasa kaharaya kata bamashasa. Rokoto shasa kabaraya ya katabama shasakaha rakata shasaka baraya kata shasaka baraya kata rokoto shasaka baraya katabama shoso kogohoro yokoto rokoto shasaka baraya kata shasaka baraya kata shasaka hara ya bama shasaka hara ya kata shasa. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, dear God. Rakata shasaka baraya kata shasaka hara ya kata rikiti shasa baraya kata shasaka hara ya kata shosoko horo yobo shosoko horo yoko shasara ya ka shasaka hara ya kata bama shasakahara yakata shosokohoro yokoto bama shasakahara yakata. Lord, as you prepare our minds and our hearts to receive your word, dear God, shasakahara yakata bama shasakahara yaba shosokohoro yoshosokoboro yokoto. We receive your wisdom and discernment, dear God. Hashisiki hara yakata shasakaba rokoto shosokohoro yobo mashasakahara yaba shasara yakata shasakabara yakata sha. Lord, the word you have prepared for us, dear God, will change our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So kids, for today's lesson, I would like for us to read from the book of Matthew 9, okay? If you have your Bible with you, you can go to Matthew 9, okay? Our verse will come from Matthew 9:28. And the topic for the book, for the reading today is only believe, okay? Only believe. Kids, I would like to start with something before I explain the chapter today. Matthew 9 is a very, very important chapter. It is filled with this topic of believing, okay? If you look back, if you look through the whole of the chapter Matthew 9, you will discover that that is when Matthew was called to be a disciple of Jesus. So that is a very important point to note, okay? So even reading from Matthew 9 and going to our verse, Matthew was called to be a disciple of Jesus from this book, from this chapter. So the chapter reads as follows. And when he had come into the house, the blind man came to him. He, in this point, refers to Jesus, okay? When Jesus had come into the house, two blind men came to him, and Jesus said to them, do you believe, okay? Do you believe that I am able to do this, okay? Do you believe that I am able to make you well? Because they wanted Jesus to make them see again. And they said to him, yes, Lord, we believe. Being that our topic today is only believe, when you read the whole chapter of Matthew 9, we begin with a story of friends bringing a paralytic man to Jesus to heal them. They brought this man to Jesus to heal them. They were just friends, and Jesus saw their faith, and their faith in that they believed that Jesus could heal this man, and Jesus healed them. In that same chapter, while discussing this topic of believing, you see a man whose daughter had just died, and he came to Jesus saying, "I believe that you can make my daughter well." Children, imagine, this person's daughter had died already, but this person came to Jesus believing. It's because of what they had heard before. Another instance of believing. In this same chapter, children, you remember the miracles of Jesus that we learned, the woman who was bleeding for several years. She came and believed that just by touching the garment of Jesus, she would be made well. Okay? And in this same chapter, we are seeing these two blind men who came to Jesus. Now, our focus will be on these two blind men. Why? This is very important. These men were blind. They had never seen Jesus. They had never seen anything happening around them. There was no evidence whatsoever of anything happening around them. But they had heard, very important, they had heard of the miracles of Jesus, what Jesus was doing around them. And just by hearing, just by listening to this, they believed that Jesus would make them well. Okay? So everyone in this chapter is believing, not by seeing, but by hearing what did Jesus had done before, and believing that the same way they had these miracles happen, in the same way they will be made well. So look, these two blind men, they crowd out to Jesus for healing, okay? And I want us to know that they were completely blind. They were lacking this ability. And when Jesus told them, asked them, "Do you believe that I can make you well?" Okay? Jesus asked them that question. They cried out to Jesus and they said, "Yes, Lord." Okay? "Yes, Lord." It is important to note here the usage of the word Lord. Okay? Lord means he has power over this. Okay? He has power over you. He has influence over you. So they believed that God, that Jesus had the power and the influence to help them overcome that challenge of blindness. Okay? It was a challenge to them. And they believed Jesus as Lord over it. Okay? The same way, children, what you're learning today, the same way these blind men believed Jesus' power and influence over their illness is the same way we are asked as Christians to believe. As children, we are asked to believe that God has power, he has influence over whatever trouble we are passing through, over whatever challenge we are passing through. The only thing we have to do, kids, we have to pray over it. We have to believe that Jesus already has done it. He already did it by his death on the cross. That is why, as Christians, we have this power within us. So you believe whatever thing you want God to have power over it, pray over it, and believe that it is already done for you. That you have power and you have influence over that challenge over you. So believe that it is already done and it will be done for you. Okay? So all you have to do is believe, and that is key. Believe for a miracle for yourself or for someone else, okay? If you want to see a miracle in someone else's life, besides that of your own, believe that it will be made well and you pray for it. Praise the Lord. We have this power within us, okay, kids? So that is the lesson for today. Only believing, and with a myriad of examples given before you, kids, okay? You have several examples to pick from, and you know what to say. You know God has power and influence over it. So for today, kids, I would like for us to say this confession, okay? And for the confession today, I believe in miracles, for I believe in God. This is so powerful, so I would like for us to repeat this again, okay? I believe in miracles, for I believe in God, okay? And for the memory verse, kids, it comes from the book of Mark 9:23, okay? Mark this, Mark 9, verse 23. Jesus said unto him, "If you can believe, all things are possible to him that believes." Jesus is telling you, you only need to believe. All things are possible for he that believes. Okay? So kids, this is our lesson today. That is the memory verse that we are going with at home, that we are going to repeat, and concentrate on, and know that everything is possible if we believe. So I'd like for us to thank God for this opportunity. We'd say a word of prayer before we close our lesson for today. Thank you, God, for the gift of your word today. Thank you, Father. And we believe that your Holy Spirit has given us this discernment, God, that your kids have been able to take in the word, and they will be able to use the power and influence, Father, that is bestowed unto them to speak over the challenges in their lives, dear God, or to speak over the challenges in other people's lives around them, and miracles will happen if only they believe. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. So kids, thank you for taking this opportunity to learn together with us. I pray that we will be able to do this more often, and as soon as possible, we'll meet together again. I'd like to wish you a wonderful week ahead and a blessed Sunday. Thank you. Bye-bye.